Like many teenagers, our next act, Emily Cunliffe, looks to her mum for inspiration.
Now my mum's an actress, but back in the day she was actually in a pop band called Hearsay.
My name's Kim and I am Emily's mum.
You okay, sweetie?
Pure and Simple. That's a good song, that.
I used to be my mum's biggest fan, actually, you know. I've still got all her, like, album on my phone, like, I never really put it on.
My mum actually got a big break on a singing competition like this.
What is it like for you, Kim? Because it's kind of gone full circle. How many years ago was it that you did it?
Nearly 14.
It was you sat here.
I know, yeah.
About to audition and walk into that room, so you know how she is feeling. And you also know now how your mum was feeling.
Yeah, couldn't sleep last night. I mean, I've been nervous in a good way. I'm so proud of her.
I don't think I sound anything like my mum. But my mum always says that I'm much better than she was at her age.
She's done so well to come this far and she's still so young. I mean, I was 24 when I did Popstar, so she's 16.
Was there any part of you, Kim, that didn't want her to do it?
Yeah, of course. The thing is with Emily, she's so headstrong, she'd have done it anyway.
Yeah. Done it on the sly.
She inspires me in that kind of thing because she never gave up. No, I love her. She's great. Just because she's my mum doesn't mean that I'm not my own person. I don't want to be known as just Kim's daughter.
I've got a feeling, I've got a good feeling about this.
Selfish pain, it was worth it every time. 'Cause you are a piece of me I wish I didn't need. Chasing relentlessly, still fighting, I don't know why. If all love is tragedy,
I made a mistake here. What's your name, love?
Emily.
Where are you from?
Manchester.
How old are you?
16.
16. I can't criticize you because I don't think there's anything to criticize. It was all there and well, you sounded lovely. On reflection, I should have hit my button. So I'm sorry about that.
I had a tiny speck of doubt to press my button. I was there, and I did press it, but too late. Did you see that? It was brilliant.
Thank you.
I don't know what that seed of doubt was in my mind that stopped me doing it earlier, but it was there. You are what I'm looking for on my team, but I didn't press the button in time.
You see, it pushed it too late. I saw him do it.
We four coaches ordered well-done steak, right? That's the metaphor. But the temperature that you were cooking it at the beginning didn't really cook it well done to now open up the steak and it's red in the inside. And I asked the lady, excuse me, I asked for well done, it's still bloody. It's not that people don't like medium rare. It's just that we asked for well done.
I like medium rare.
Yeah.
I like my metaphors.
A lot.
A lot. For example.
There's so many female singers. You need to make sure that you stand out for yourself. So I think you have so much time on your hands to go and figure out what it is that will make people remember you. Because you're beautiful, you've got an incredible tone, but you have now got this opportunity to go away and tell yourself in the mirror, what am I gonna do to stand out amongst all these other females in this music industry? And when you figure that out, please come back.
Thank you. You okay?
You got plenty of time.
Okay,
plenty of time. You got plenty of time.
Thank you.
Do you want to go see
it? Yeah.
She's going to be gutted. Absolutely gutted.
You did fantastically. Just a baby. You did so well. Hey, you did so well. You did.
Oh, you did brilliant, baby.
I was thinking about it.
Yeah, I was too, but there was when there's that seed of doubt.
I know.
If she comes back in a year or two, she'll be fine.
Yeah.
Those are horrible. We hate them. And we get down. And it really affects us all. Because we've all been there.
We know what it's like to be on stage and to go through auditions and for somebody to say, no. It's hard. It's a hard thing.
You know, when I started, I got dropped 3 times from 3 different record labels. I was so frustrated and I was so aggravated with myself. But I'd never lose my hunger, and I never have, and I never will. So they shouldn't either.
Because to say for every door that closes, one opens. No, bruh. For every door that closes in the parking lot, there's a key for a bulldozer. Don't be waiting for somebody to knock on a door. That was yesterday.
Ding dong. Hey, I want to sing.
No, bruh. Can you give me the key to that bulldozer so I can break down this freaking wall? That's what we need right now. We need that.